Welcome to Everett Memorial Stadium. Everett against the Everett Crimson Tide against the Reading Rockets. September, what is today? 17th. I think it's the 18th, actually. We're going to be starting in a few minutes. It looks like Reading is on the toss, and they're going to defer. They're going to kick. Reading's going to kick to the right to Everett in the first half. Okay, Reading will be kicking off to the Everett Crimson Tide. This is Lucas Fleming kicking off. He's been a kicker for 2 years now. Been very effective. Let's see how this goes. A lot of onside kicks, but I think he's going deep. Ball's loose. Still loose. Nice coverage. Good coverage by the Rockets. Looked like number 9, Jay Kajenda, was on that ball. And Ray will start on defense. McEverett will be at about the 35-yard line. Okay, ready. Everett starting from the 35-yard line. We got Troy Pollock at safety. Redding's packed in there pretty tight. Blast up the middle. There's nothing there. Nothing. Oh, he's loose. Getting loose. Very loose. It looked like Danny O'Connor in there. Maybe another 73, Patrick Duras. But that middle was just stuffed up. Nothing there at all. Okay, Everett goes second, looks like about 9 yards from the 35-yard line. Pitch to the right, drives up the middle. It's about 4 or 5 yards. Looks like in on the tackle was number 24, Lucas Lorenza, and 44, Stephen Needham. At 3rd and 6, be good for the Rockets to stop him right here, establish something right off the bat. Don't know if Everett can throw, but I imagine we're going to see some boys in the backfield spread out a little bit. Again, packed in tight. Another blast, nice tackle. Nope, he was down. Number 44 is in there, Stephen Needham. Okay, 4th down, 4th and 5. I'm expecting the punt. Troy Pollock will probably be dropping back. It's a good stop there to establish yourself early in this game. We're at their field, obviously, to their advantage. Oh, they're packed in. No punt here. They're going for it. 4th and 5. Fake pitch. Rolls out. It's dropped. Great coverage there. Great coverage. We've got a first down for the Reading Rockets. That's a, looks like Stephen Needham on him. Nothing happening there. Good job by the Rockets. At quarterback, it looks like we have Dom G. Crescenzo and Lucas Fleming. Split out to the right is Patrick Dwyer, and in the slot, it looks like David, that can't be David Lynch, he's a lineman. Run up the middle. Number 23, Lucas Fleming. That's good for 4 yards. Number 32, Dom G. Crescenzo gets the play back to the huddle. We got Brendan Fox in the slot. That's who I missed. Again, DiLorenzo and Fleming in the backfield. The snap. Oh, we have flags here. I don't know who it's going to be on motion, or did they just jump? Oh, looks like 5 yards on Everett. Okay, we're going to have 2nd and about a yard. Snap to DiLorenzo. Blast up the middle. Great blocking by the offensive line. That's good for about 7 yards. Great job. He's opened a huge hole. He jumped through it quickly. Now Fleming's going to get the play and bring it in. He was on that line. Number 50, Logan Fortuna. Number 70, Peter Mirgianis. 72, David Swanson. That's where they broke the hole open from. 51, Giancarlo Musto. There goes Fleming again. Oh, he's hit. Looks like a 1 yard loss, and Everett was on that quickly. Looks like they have the speed. Redding's a speed team, and I think they have their match today. It's going to be second and about 13, 14 yards. I would imagine this is four down territory, so I'm sure the coach is accounting for that in his play calling. Same set, Dwyer's out to the left, Fox out his split in the slot on the left. Dom DiCrescenza bowling through there for a good 5 yard run. Here's Redding switching their offense. They were very effective doing this last week. And that's what wore the Wilmington Wildcats down. They were a little short on the roster, and by the end of the game, I think they're a little tired out. Redding stays very fresh. You might see the same thing. Everett doesn't have a lot of uniforms over there either. They are known as a very good team, however. It's Pollock taking the snap. Fake to Lucas Fleming, rolls out, nice pass. There's DiCrescenzo to the 15, down to about the 10-yard line. That's a first down for the Rockets. Well-designed play. Everett read it well, got on, but Pollock avoided that, the blitzer, and made a nice pass to a wide-open Dom DiCrescenzo. First and goal. Yes, it's first and goal at the 10. If they can get a first down, it would be at about the 1-inch line. So let's call it first and goal. Pollock right up the middle off the snap. Oh, he is elusive. Good job. We'll give him 5 on that and call it first and goal from the second and goal from the 5. Offensive line doing a good job again. We've got number 81, Zach Kenyon, 65. That is Anthony Masucci. Dan Damari's back there. Split left, Trevor Conroy. In the slot is Zach Kenyon. Hand off to Lucas Fleming, powers his way up the middle. I think he's in. Touchdown, Rockets. It's a good sign, this, establishing himself early against a very, very good team. Good blocking. Steven Needham's having another game. He had a great week last week. Number 52, Mason Dion. In there on the line. Looks like Sean Cronin, number 64. Really just blew the line up 2 plays in a row. Good 5 yard gains and the touchdown. Going for 1 point in Pop Warner. Going for it gives you 1 point. Kicking gives you 2. Mari in motion. Looks like Pollock's keeping it, and I believe he's in for the touchdown for the extra point. So excellent beginning for the Rockets. 7-0 early in the first quarter. All right, we're going to kick off from the 40. Lucas Fleming. Onside, good bounce. Everett picks it up, runs out to the 40, and we'll have first and 10 for the Crimson Tide heading right to left. Everett breaks the huddle. They're a little more split this time. They're getting them a 7 split wide. Last time they're all packed in. You might see the ball in the air this time. Going to end around. Great hit. That looks like Damarian Pollock. We have a flag come in late. Not sure what it is, but Dan Damari just came in there and blew that play up quickly. Let's see what the... It looks like it's against Everett. They're talking to the Rockets. I might see them decline this unless it's a big one. No, it looks like the coach is going to take this. I'm going to guess it's a holding 10 yards from the 40. Push him back. So we'll have first and 20 from the 30-yard line. And Dan Damari came storming in there. That was quite a tackle. He had help, so if he did just slow him down, he would have had a lot of help. This is a very swarming defense. They'll come out of nowhere. Again, we're split. We have four receivers set for the Crimson Tide, two men in the backfield. Drops back, good penetration by O'Connor. DeCrescenzo's chasing. Looks like Needham pushed him out. Then I think we got DeCrescenzo and Lucas Fleming pushing him out of bounds. That was a good 12-yard gain, however. Actually, I'll give him 14. Oh, another flag over there. Might be a late hit on the Rockets. It is out of bounds. That's what it looks like. Personal foul, late hit on the Rockets. So we'll have first and 10 on the Rocket 40. Every Crimson Tide moving right to left. Not sure what this is. Now, end of the quarter. That was a quick quarter. Beginning of the second quarter, Everett again is split with four receivers. Fake handoff up the middle. Quarterback splinting right. Oh, I got a flag. That's going to come back. It looks like a clip. Block in the back. One. That's Sean Beckenhouse on the tackle. There was a clip on the in the backfield. A lot of laundry. Still first down. Still first down. First down and 19 from midfield. See what Everett comes out. They started with the first set. They packed everything in and tried to bust it up the middle. Now they have four receiver sets with two in the backfield. Looks like they want to open it up against the Rockets. Drop back as a pass. Great coverage, but the great catch. Great coverage by Patrick Duras. He couldn't have covered him any tighter. That's a big receiver he's got against, number 9. Looks like he's short of the first down. We're going to have second and, I'd say, a foot. Again, in the wide spread. Number 4 in motion. Handoff. I don't know. It's very close. Very close. Great defense by the Rockets. I saw Beckenhouse in there, number 9. Jake Agenda. Coming into the game, number 24, Lucas Lorenza. Actually, that was a loss. We're going to have third and about one and a half. David Lynch comes out of the game. I believe he might have been on that tackle either. He clogs the middle very well. Third and one. Quick quarterback keeper. I think this might be motion. We have another flag. Quick snap. Tackle by number 41, Sean Beckenhouse. Sean Cronin in on that. Yes, we have it against Everett. We just got a little too quick a start. All right, we have third and 6. I'll be honest, it's hard to keep track of down and yardage with all the flags so far. Third down, I'd say 6 yards. They need the 30-yard line. Spread wide again. Snap in the pocket, got some time. Here comes the coverage. That's a short pass, Pollock. Pollock tipped that. Great job. Troy Pollock had that, just tipped it enough the receiver couldn't get it. Good coverage, and then the Rockets came in charging hard. Number 24, Lucas Lorenzo was giving pressure. 32, Dom DiCrescenzo. Okay, we have 4th down and 6. They need the 30-yard line. A little bit over the 30, it looks like. I'd expect Evers to throw again. Quarterback's got a good arm. 4 receivers, tall receivers. Redding's done a good job so far. It's just the 1 reception and it's great coverage. So you have Stevie Needham and Patrick Duras out to the right on their receivers. Quarterback's looking the other way. There's coverage. Great catch. Great catch. Evan Thies on that. Again, good coverage. Just a great pass. This kid really is effective. First down and goal, I'd say it's on the 3-yard line. Now I expect them to come out in that tight set. That's what it looks like. Big quarterback. Under center, number 4 behind him. Let's see if he keeps it or quick blast. Quick blast, good stop by the Rockets. The whole middle of the line, just nothing there. Nothing there. Lucas Lorenza. Number 9, Jake Agenda. I think Sean Cronin was on that. Here comes Cronin out, Lynch going back in, David Lynch. Hard to tell from here, but it looks like he got a yard, maybe half a yard. Second and goal from the 1.5, 2-yard line, 2-yard line. Same set. Reddy's got everybody in the box. Fake. Roll out to the right. Receiver open. Oh, right through his hands. Right through his hands. So we're going to have 3rd and goal from the 2. Steven Needham and Patrick Duras. Again, good coverage. Thank you. down. Goal at the two. He rolls right again. Similar play. Same play. Not open this time. He's going to run. Touchdown, Everett. We do have another flag, however. Let's hope this comes back the rock. Goes the Rockets' way. Looks like this Lorenz is clapping. I think this is going to be another penalty on Everett. That's a big one, too. That's going to be another hold. We're going to have third and goal from the 11. Rockets cover that play very well that time. They must have seen it. It was the same play, and they smelled it. And there was nothing to throw at. The quarterback, very athletic, ran for it. It's hard to cut both the receiver and the ball carrier. Packed in tight again. Four in motion. Fake pitch. Handoff up. Great play. Oh, Sean Beckenhouse smelled that one out. Decked the back in the backfield. Look at that fourth and long. Fourth and goal. We call it the 15-yard line. Beckenhouse just busted right through it. He wasn't fooled by the fake pitch. Fourth and goal from the 15. We're going to spread out again. Expect a pass. Looks like we've got man-to-man coverage. Snap to the quarterback. He drops it. There's another flag down. Almost picked off. Actually, the pass was underthrown. I think if he threw it right, Evan Thies would have had that picked off. And Pollock was out there too, Troy Pollock. I think you're going to see this one decline. It's going to be the Rockets' ball. No, I think this might be on the Rockets, unfortunately. Okay, let's repeat fourth down. We're at the 10-yard line. Fourth and goal, 10-yard line, Crimson Tide with the ball. So Freddie could hold this one more play, that'd be a big gain. Yeah, the fans are wondering what the call is. Not a lot of indication from the referee, or we're just missing him. There's no white hat out there. I usually look for the white hat. Ball! Ball's on the ground. Hey, it's Redding's ball no matter what, fourth down. I don't know if Everett was mixed up. The ball was not transferred at all. The quarterback gave and the running back didn't pick it, it looks like. Great defense. So even if he caught it and handed that off, it would have been gone nowhere. So let's take a break. Start it up. Okay, first down for the Rockets. We're about the 15-yard line, 14-yard line. Looks like Pollock's going to be taking the snap with Dan Damari in the backfield. Split left is Trevor Conroy and Steven Needham. Evan Thies in motion. Pollock keep big hole. Oh, he's so good. Great block by Steven Needham. Out to the 26-yard line. He's very nifty. He's a fast and elusive runner. It's a great fake. Sean Cronin threw a great block there. Steven Needham threw a great block. Looks like Danny O'Connor out there. Evan Thies, he went through the hole first in motion. It's a big game for the Rockets. Gets them out of jail back there. And now they have first down at the 37-yard line. Okay, Pollock to take the snap again. Damari in the backfield with him. Thies in motion again. Same thing in reverse. But this time he gets it to Damari. Busts up the middle. He's another elusive runner. I'm going to give him about 5 yards. He had space in there, and he used it very well. Cronin, great block. Danny O'Connor, great block. And David Lynch again. And we have a man down for Everett. Rockets break the huddle. Again, Pollock to take the snap. Damari behind him. Thies in motion. Fake. Pollock. Another nifty move. Oh, we're coming back. Unfortunately, it looks like a hold on Redding. There's nowhere for Pollock to go on that. Everett read it very well. Waiting for an indication. It looks like it's against Everett. Nope, coming back against the Rockets. I'm gonna say that was a hole. We're not getting an indicator from the referee, unfortunately. It's 10 yards, we know that. Okay, so we're gonna have second and 15, 14 yards. Timeout Redding. Okay, we have second and 14 yards for the Rockets. They took a timeout. 33-yard line. Rockets leading 7-0. I'd say it's about 5-6 minutes in the second quarter. We don't have a clock here, unfortunately, today. Scoreboard reads 27-6. That was from the previous game, so we'll have to keep that in our heads here. Snap to Pollock. Rolls out. He's got him. He's got Damari. Just a tiny bit overthrown. Good coverage by Everett. Troy put it out there nicely. Looked like a good pass. Little bit overthrown. Okay, we have third and 14. Good protection. Anthony Masucci protecting. Lucas Lorenza. Steven Needham in the middle snapping. Okay, now we have Lucas Fleming in the backfield with Damari. Fake to Fleming. Pollock breaks out of the snap. Sprints right. Great cut. Use a block. Troy Pollock, great run. All over the field. Tough to bring down. I'm going to give him 13 yards. We're going to have fourth and one. Tough call for the coach here. We are in Everett territory. I'm going to give about 4 minutes left in the half. Troy's getting up slowly. I think we're going to have an injury timeout. He's going to kick. Okay, we have a new offense out there. We have fourth and that's a yard, a solid yard. In the backfield we have Lucas Fleming and Dom DiCrescenzo. Split left is Pat Dwyer in the slot, Brendan Fox. This was the team that started the game. The power four formation. It's Lucas Fleming. First down, 50-yard line. I see another flag. Oh, I stand corrected, not a flag. Looked like a towel or something fell on the sideline. My apologies. Exactly at midfield. This is what Reading needed. They started at their own 10, and one big play got out, and here we are, midfield. Let's get some points. They break, same set. Fleming and DiLorenzo in the backfield, Fox in the slot. Number 12, Dylan Lee on the tight end. Pat Dwyer split right. DiCrescenzo busts up the middle. Power run for 3-4 yards. Redding calls a timeout, I believe. Yes. Okay, Redding breaks out to the field. We have Troy Pollock and Lucas Fleming in the backfield this time. Dan Damari in the slot. Second and 7. I'm going to give about 2 minutes left. Redding's starting to use their timeout, so we've got to get low on the clock. Fake handoff up the middle. He's got the man wide open. Just a tiny bit overthrown. Great pass, though. Patrick Duras out there. I think he... That stops the clock, which helps a little. But now we're going to have third and seven. Trevor Conroy splits out to the right. Patrick Duras, tight end. Troy Pollock's going to take the snap again. He's got Dan Damari standing next to him. Fake handoff to Lucas Fleming. Same play in reverse. And we're going to have fourth down. Fourth and seven from the Everett 47-yard line. Not much time left on the clock. I'm going to say about a minute and a half. Those two plays didn't eat much time, unfortunately, if we have to punt. But it looks like we're going to go for it. Again, you have Pollock in the backfield behind Lucas Fleming. Damari in the slot, decent motion. Got a pass. He's got Duras again. Good bid. We're going to have first down for Everett. All right, you ready? All right, Everett will be kicking off left to right. It's the beginning of the second half. Reading leads 7-0. Pretty even half. I'd give that a little bit of an edge to Reading. They had the one big defensive stop and the one touchdown drive. Reading ball blows off the tee. Deep we have Dan Damari and Troy Pollock. Here we go. Big kick. Blues the whistle, and Reading will take over at the 20. I'm sorry. Yeah, this is Dan Damari. Very good run. I'm going to give him 5 yards. Good start. All right, comes a late flag. Late flag. It's going to be after the play, so the down is going to count. Referees confer. We're not getting much of a signal from the referees today, unfortunately. The coaches are notified, which is all that counts. Penalty on the Rockets. Again, the down is going to count 10 yards from the spot, it looks like, of the penalty. No, we're going back even further. Back to the 11-yard line. So it's going to be 15 yards from the spot. Personal foul. Didn't get a number. So we have second and 17. Reading breaks the huddle. Pat Dwyer split left. Brendan Fox in the slot again. We have Lucas Fleming and Dominic DiCrescenzo in the backfield. Snap to Fleming. Off the left side. Cuts up. Bout back to scrimmage. That's going to leave us 3rd and 17. Big chunk for the Rockets. DiCrescenzo comes out. We have Damari coming in for him. More of a speed set, although DiCrescenzo can move. Fleming, Damari takes the snap, goes off the left side. Not much there. A couple of yards, and then it's 4th and long. I expect a punt right here. Fourth and 17 for the Rockets. I see Lucas Fleming most likely drop back to punt. Average return is on their on the Rocket 40, so they expect to get the ball in Rocket territory. Good kick by Fleming. Ball bounces, comes back to the Rocket, right at the 40-yard line. Unfortunate bounce for the Rockets, but a great kick by Fleming. Into a little bit of a breeze. Nice day for football. No sun, but it's warm and we'll take it, because come November, we'll appreciate days like this for football.
Joe!
Williams and Ty take over in the Reading, on the Reading 40-yard line, first and 10. It's packed tight again. They've alternated between this set and four wide. Pitch number 21 off the left side. Good coverage. We get Lucas Lorenza in there. Looks like Jay Kajender, number 9. Damari on there. Again, that swarming Reading defense. Danny O'Connor coming out. He was in on the tackle. 41, Sean Beckenhouse. Adam Deemer, number 15. Second and 7 for the Crimson Tide. Again in the tight formation. Number 3 in motion, pitch out to the right side. Good yardage for Everett, steps out of bounds at about the 24-yard line. Stephen Needham, Dan Damari, number 84, Evan Thies on the tackle. Everett starting to move the ball a little better. Reading gave him in good field position. Ball at the 24-yard line. Again in the tight formation. First and 10, 24-yard line for the Crimson Tide. Bust up the middle. Everybody from the Reading is in on the tackle. I see Adam Deemer on the bottom of the pile. We got Lucas Lorenza, Sean Beckenhouse, and Dom DiCrescenzo. Danny O'Connor back in the game for Adam Deemer. Just a yard for the Crimson Tide. That's a setup play, and you have to watch what they're going to run off of that. Second and 9 from the Reading 23-yard line. Single back formation, two men on the wing. Number 3 in motion, fake pitch. Hand off to number 1 up the middle. Give him 3 yards. Bottom of the pile, Sean Beckenhouse again. Danny O'Connor on the tackle. Third and 6.5, 7 yards. Again, probably 4-down territory here. Again, a single back, 2 wings, one on either side, number 4 in motion. They pitch it to him. Sweep to the right. Reading catches up. Looks like he's about 2 yards short. Number 9, Jake Gender on the tackle. Again, Beckenhouse out there. Reading's doing a good job containing the line. We have 4th and 2. It's a key play right here. Everett's looking to tie the game. Fourth and about two, number four in motion. Pitch to number four off the left side. Looks like he does have the first down. Great, like Steven Needham on that, and maybe again Sean Beckenhaus. But it's a first down for the Everett Crimson Tide inside the 10. Just at about the 10, but they dropped the stick, so it's going to be first and goal from the 10. Fake handoff up the middle, pass in the end zone, incomplete. Great coverage over there, number 73, Pat Duras. Troy Pollock helping him out, and then it looks like Steven Needham. While I have a second, talk about the boys who won't be going in the game today due to some injuries. We have awesome Joe Gilligan, number 33. Jaheim Nortelis, number 7. And there is another deal. Max Ramos is also not going to be playing today. Pop Warner is very careful about their injuries, and if boys are hurt, they're not going to play, and that's a very good thing. We have second and goal from a 10-yard line. Now he's swinging out to the right. Great job by Lucas Fleming bringing the quarterback, putting pressure on him. Lucas Fleming, big kid who can move with anybody. Great speed. Good coverage out there. I'm going to give credit to the coverage again. Pat Duras. Third and goal from the 10 for Crimson Tide. Fake again, handoff number four up the middle. Big contact. Redding was there. Got about 4 yards, but again, that swarming defense. Beckenhaus. Looks like Needham. Dominic DiCrescenzo. I think Lucas Lorenzo might have been in there. Very few tackles for Redding without two or three gentlemen on them. Fourth down, big play for the Rockets. This is a big play in the game. Conserve that lead, get the ball back. It's the key. Spread formation again for Everett. They're alternating back and forth. Most likely going to throw. You might see the quarterback run. He's very nifty. A little confusion. Timeout, Everett. Fourth and goal, 7-yard line. Everett Crimson Tide split wide. Snap. Ball's in the air. Looks like a completion, touchdown Everett. Great pass through, and none of the Rockets could put a hand on it. And a great catch picking it up off the ground. Now 7-6 Rockets. See what Everett chooses to do here. Again, a kick is worth two in Pop Warner. Conversion on a standard play is worth one. I think it looks like they're going for one to tie the game. Again, split wide. Snap. Jake Agenda puts some pressure on the quarterback. Great pass. Say this kid's got a good arm, Redding. Nothing to be ashamed of. Conversion good, game tied. When they get all spread out. Okay, we're late in the third quarter. 7-7. Everett will be kicking off to Redding. wind is kicking up, and I think it's going to be in more in Redding's face in the third quarter, which is an advantage because they'll have the wind in the fourth quarter. More of a cross breeze. Ball off the tee again. Gonna have to hold that. Last time this boy kicked off, it was very deep, so we have Pollock and Damari back around the 10-yard line. Surprised they didn't kick for two with this with the strength of his leg. Oh, a little onside kick. That's trouble. Out of bounds at the 30-yard line. We had this last week, and I believe the ball's going to be placed on the 30-yard line as a penalty. Oh, man down. Back late in the third quarter, we have a tie game between Redding and Everett, 7-7. Got a player down on that kickoff. Great block by Dominic DiCrescenzo. Slow getting up, but I think he's going to be okay. It's a great block. Ball is kicked out of bounds, and Redding will take it over at the 35-yard line on the penalty. First and 10 Rockets at their own 35. In the backfield, we're going to have Troy Pollock and Dan Damari. Lucas Fleming. Actually, they have a three-man set out there. Fleming. Oh, snap. Pitch to Damari. Off the try block. Still going. Still going. We got a flag down. Bust out to the 50-yard line. Unfortunately, I think that's going to come back. We have two flags down. Rockets break the huddle. We're going to start the fourth quarter. Again, we're tied 7-7. We had a holding penalty on Redding on that. We're going to bring that great run back. Start from the 25-yard line. We're at the Rockets 25. Evan Thies in motion. Faked beautiful run by Troy Pollock. Excellent run. We got 15, 16 yards on that run. Great fake to Lucas Fleming, who took the punishment, but it was well worth the 16 yards. Of course, I'm not Lucas. I wasn't the one that got hit. I'll give him 17 on that. Second and 3 for Redding. Same set, same players out there. Anthony Masucci on the line. Stephen Needham snapping the ball. Lucas Lorenzo on the line with Pat Duras. Damari in the slot. Fleming behind Pollock, Evan Thies in motion. Hand off to Lucas Fleming. Comes up the middle. Still going. First down. That's a great run by Lucas Fleming, keeping his balance. Hit right at about the line of scrimmage. Powered his way. Looked like he was going down. Kept his balance and got the first down. We're going to have first and 10 for Redding on their own 46-yard line. That's the power set, and if we had a lead, that would be what we see. But I think the Rocks got to move the ball down the field, get some points. Jake Agenda in there as well. Same set. We got Pollock at quarterback, Lucas Fleming behind him. Troy Conroy split right to Mari, and here comes Evan Thies in motion. Another handoff. That's to Lucas Fleming. Try to spin out. Good, great tackle by Everett. It's a loss of three. Second and 13 for Reading. Different set. We have Evan Thies split out right here. Dan DeMari in motion, takes the ball. Not much room, but he stays on his feet, keeps the balance. Another good run by, give him 3-4 yards on that. Everett read that play well. Jamari was good to get 4 yards. Third and 8 for Reading on their own 48-yard line. Jake Adanja checking the play with Pollock. Fake, Pollock up the middle. Pollock keeps staying, still going. He's about a yard and a half, 2 yards short, but another, it's very nifty in there. Wasn't too much room, and he's got a nice 8-yard gain. 7-yard gain, I apologize. We're gonna have 4th and 1, interesting call here. They are on the Everett 45-yard line. Tie game 7-7, early fourth quarter. Unfortunately, our clock is not functioning today, and we have to guess the time of the game. Penalty, most likely going to be illegal formation, or it's going to be on Reading because the whistle was blown before the snap. Now we're going to have 4th and 6. I'm sure there'll be a different play called here, right at midfield. Troy Pollock getting the play from Adam Pollock and heads back to the huddle with it. 4th down 6, big play here, right at midfield. The game's been very even. The first half was more Reading. I think Everett might have a little bit of an advantage here in the second, but Reading gets a first down here, certainly to their advantage. Pollock takes a snap, fake. Interception, but I think we might have pass interference. Might even have a face mask. It might have been a grab of the face mask. I think that's going to be first down Reading. Again, we're not getting a good indication from the officials, unfortunately. It's definitely on an Everett. And if it's pass interference, it's first down. They're moving the chains. First down Rockets, big play. And to be honest with you, I think the player was trying to jump in there. Might have just got a little bit of the face mask or the shoulder pads while he was going for the ball, and therefore it was pass interference. Didn't see, it might have been Dom DiCrescenzo. And he was definitely hit before the ball got there. Mari in motion, another flag. Pollock gets about a yard. We're gonna have offside on Everett. That's First down and five. I think Evan might be a little frustrated by that pass interference call, and lost a little cool, I think. We got first and five. Good situation from the Rockets. Might be a time to gamble a little here. Then again, they are moving the ball. Jamari next to Pollock, Thies in motion. Hand off to Fleming, big hole. Big hole, we got a first down. I see Anthony Masucci, he opened part of that hole, number 24, Lucas Lorenza. Dom DiCrescenzo, Stephen Needham, the center, certainly was in on that, opening a big gap. First down, Reading at the 33-yard line, at the Everett 33-yard line. I guess 4 or 5 minutes in the fourth quarter. Decent motion. Pollock keeps up the middle, gets loose. He's got the edge. Pollock down to the 15, 10. Pollock's going, touchdown, touchdown Rockets. DiCrescenzo threw a great block on that play. So did Lucas Lorenzo, just knocked the guys down. Anthony Masucci out there. And of course, Stephen Needham as the center, usually critical on any play. That's gonna be 13-7 Rockets and a key extra point conversion coming up. So Pollock busted through the middle, had about a 5-6 yard, and then it was rest of it was him. He cut off a block, headed down the sideline. His elusiveness and his speed was just too much for a very fast Everett team. Play coming in for the extra point conversion. They run that from the 2 yard line, just like the pros. 2.5, I guess it would be. Four-man set. We got Damari, Conway out left, Thies, and DiCrescenzo right. Damari behind Pollock. Bad snap. He picks it up. He's running left. Gets to the corner. Looks like he's in. Touchdown or extra point. I apologize. So we have 14-7 Reading. And I'm going to say we're late in the fourth quarter. Maybe 3 minutes, 4 minutes left. Okay, Reading leads 14-7. Wish I had a time for it. I'd say about 3 minutes in the fourth quarter. We have Lucas Fleming kicking off. Kick gets down around the 25-yard line. Ball's on the ground, picked up by Everett, run up the middle. Danny O'Connor's there. Big hit by Jay Beckenhaus. The 52 in there. Mason Dion. Adam Deemer comes off the field. Mason Dion and Zach Kenyon. Okay, so it's at the 36-yard line, Everett's own 36. Reading up by a touchdown and an extra point. Extra points not automatic in Pop Warner like it is at the pro level. Everett split wide again. They're opening up the field. First and 10. Quarterback keeps up the middle. I'm gonna give him 3 yards. Hard to tell who made the tackle. I see number, Jonathan Grady getting up. No, that's David Lynch, Jay Beckenhaus, Danny O'Connor. I keep saying Jay Beckenhaus. I apologize. It's Sean Beckenhaus. 2 minute warning. 2 minutes left in the game. Reading leading 14-7. We're at Everett. Everett's got the ball at their own 39-yard line. Uh, We have motion on Everett. So second and 7 is going to be a second and 12. Lucas Lorenzo going in the game. And David Lynch coming out. Lynchy's moving well. Last scrimmage, Lynchy had a little knock on the knee. We were a little concerned. He did play last week. He's certainly healthy today. Snap, quarterback drops back. Good pressure, pass over the middle, number 3. Great catch, and a good stick by Troy Pollock. Troy's slow getting up. Good zip on that ball. Good passing game. Surprised they're not doing it more often. They certainly have to now. They have to move the ball. I'm going to say about a minute 40 left, and Pollock's back down. Okay, first and 10 at the 49-yard line of Everett. Handoff up the middle, stopped. Still moving, and they put him back. Looks like a football. Big loss. Lucas Fleming stopped that with a Sean Beckenhouse. I apologize, Sean, for earlier mispronunciation. Jay Kajenda, Everett in the hurry up. We have second and 15. Kajenda puts good pressure, ball deep, underthrown. Great coverage again from Pat Duras. He's done a good job out there today. He's out by himself. It's the old cornerback thing. You're out on an island by yourself, and that's a big, tall receiver he's covering. Good job. Now third and 15 for the Crimson Tide. Say about a minute, a little over a minute left. They probably have some timeouts. Again, we don't have a clock today. Everett comes out from their own 44-yard line. Third and 15. Spread formation. Great pressure over the middle, overthrown. Going to be fourth down. Again, good coverage. It's Evan Thies back there. Troy Pollock back in the game. Good to see that. Good coverage by the Rockets and good pressure, too. Number 9, Jay Kajenda, right in there. Did a good job sealing the end in case the quarterback wanted to run, but at the same time, the quarterback had nowhere to go. Had to get rid of the ball before he wanted to. Fourth and 15, big play. If the Rockets can stop him here, they'll get the ball and be able to take some time off the clock or use Everett's timeouts. Fourth and 15, 44-yard line of Everett. Snap, the keep, quarterback keep. Rockets stop him. About 3 yards, that'll be Rocket ball in midfield. Great job. There's Lucas Fleming, Dan Damari in the backfield for the initial hits. That slows him down enough for that swarming defense to cover up and put him down. Okay, Redding's got the ball. First and 10 at the Everett 48. I'd say it's about a minute, maybe a little less. Pollock just takes a knee for a loss of 4. I don't see a timeout. The clock might be moving. Oh, there's the whistle. And I think that's the game. A little confused, we're getting indications that the game's over. The players are breaking the huddle, so I apologize if I said that was the game. Everett did take a timeout. Okay, second and 14. Pollock just takes a knee. Damari back as a safety in the event of a mishandle of the snap. But we believe this might be the last play. I think that's a game. Nope, another timeout, Everett. The officials are confusing us. Pollock takes another knee, and we've got third 50. That is the game. Reading Rockets. This is a huge win. Everett is known as one of the best Pop Warner programs in Massachusetts, and the Rockets just beat them 14-7 on their home field. And that is a good Everett team. We saw it today. The Rockets just played a little better, and that's the difference. Boys will shake hands, walk off after the second game. The Rockets are 2-0, and we're going to check out here and see you next week.